Good morning students, let's see the continuity of general organic chemistry. In that we call it is GOC, IUPAC names and roles. Today we are going to discuss about IUPAC names and roles, how to give the names to the organic compounds. Okay, so before going to discuss about this, we have to learn about priority order of functional group. Okay, very very important. Priority order of functional group. So already we discussed about some important functional groups. Okay, so in that some of the important functional groups we have, the priority order according to IUPAC system, in that first we give the preference to carboxylic acids, acid functional group. So it has the first priority here, then cyanides, then go for aldehydes, and then ketones and alcohols, and then amines. Ethers, and then is it clear students up to ethers? And next one, double bond, triple bond. These are the functional group priority order. Okay, so the structural functional group carboxylic acid means COOH is called like carboxylic acid group. Carboxylic acid means bond COOH. If the organic compound consists of COOH, then it is called as carboxylic acid. We can also write this C double bond OOH. This is called carboxylic acid group. Okay. Or for example, acetic acid, formula is CH3COOH. It is a carboxylic acid. Why it is carboxylic acid? It consists COOH group. We can also write this structure here, CH3 bond C double bond O OH. So this structure represents carboxylic acid. So this group gets the first priority among these. Okay. Next one, cyanide. Cyanide means it consists CN group is called as cyanide. So we can also write this bond C triple bond N, C triple bond N. This is can write as like this. Okay, triple bond is in between carbon and nitrogen. So example for this, CH3 C triple bond N or CH3 CN, methyl cyanide. Okay, aldehyde, the next one is aldehyde. Aldehydic functional group means CHO is called as aldehydic functional group. Aldehyde the compound which consists CHO, then it is called aldehyde. We can also elaborate this structure, bond C double bond O H, bond C double bond O H, bond C double bond O H. Here one side hydrogen must, okay. So for example, CH3CHO, we call it is acetaldehyde. We can also elaborate this structure as CH3 bond C double bond OH. So is the C double bond OH. You can write this as. So you can able to identify CHO as C double bond OH also. Remember this. If CHO is present in the compound, then it is called aldehydic functional group. Aldehydic functional group. COOH, it is called carboxylic acid functional group. Cyanide means CN, aldehyde means CHO. So cyanide has more priority than aldehyde. Here carboxylic acid has more priority than cyanide. Okay. Next, come to ketone. What about ketone here? In the ketone, we have. Can I rub this? So let us come to ketone. So the general structure is RCOR, am I right? Okay, these two are same or different? RC double bond O R, we can write like this. RC double bond O R dash, these two are not equal. And R dash C double bond O R dash, these two are same. Okay, so R is not a hydrogen, R or R dash not a hydrogen. Any group where R may be CH3 group, methyl group, or R may be C2HY ethyl group, am I right? Yesterday we discussed about this one. This is methyl group and this is ethyl group, am I right? Ethyl group, am I right? So whatever the group, maybe both are CH3 or C2HY. Okay, this is ketone formation. Let's take the example for ketone. For example, for ketone functional group, R is not a hydrogen, R R dash. Okay, for example, CH3COCH3. What we call it is acetone. Ketone, one is there at the end of the name. One. So we can also write this structure CH3, C double bond O, CH3. Okay? CH3. Okay, so this is the example for ketone. You can need to identify CO is there at two alkyl groups are arranged at carbon, then we call it as ketone, like this. This formation, ketones, very very important, aldehydes and ketones. And one more example, CH3COC2H5. Okay, so CH3, we can write this C double bond O, C2H5, am I right? So both here, both are different or not? Both are different. We can also write this CH3, C double bond O, C2H5 can write as CH2 bond CH3, already we discussed about that. C2H5 can write as CH2 bond CH3 or not? So C2H5 can also write as CH2 bond CH3. So two carbon, C2 and H5. C2H3. Okay, so this is our example for ketone. Let us come to alcohols. Alcohols means the compound consists of OH group, then we call it is alcoholic functional group. If the compound consists of OH group, then we call it is alcoholic functional group. Okay, so let us take the example CH3OH, methyl alcohol. Methyl group, OH is there, alcohol, methyl alcohol. Methyl alcohol. Suppose CH3 bond CH2OH. Ethyl, C2H5 means ethyl. Ethyl alcohol. Ethyl alcohol. So it is alcoholic functional group. For example, OH is there. So clearly it is alcoholic functional group is present. Then Okay, in this manner we have to identify the which type of functional group is present in the given organic compound. Is it clear, students? Up to next, amines means amines consist bond NH2 group. Bond NH2 group is called as amine functional group. For example, CH3 bond NH2, we call it is methanamine or methanamine. Okay, NH2 group is there, so we call it is methanamine. Methane plus amine, methanamine or methylamine. And C2H5 bond NH2, NH2 group is there. We can write as C2H5, CH2 bond NH2, am I right? Ethyl group, write as like this, CH3 bond, CH2 bond NH2. Ethyl amine, okay? Clear? Next, come to ether. What about ether functional group? Ether functional group here. Ether functional group means ROR, okay? Where R is not equals to hydrogen, or R, R dash O, R O R dash, both are same, R different. So this is ether formation, where these two R, or R dash is also not hydrogen. R may be CH3, methyl group, or R may be C2H5, C2H5, ethyl group may be, okay? So let's take some examples. CH3OCH3, is it in ether formation or not? So this is ether functional group, am I right? You can also write this like this. So ROR. So another example, CH3OC2H5, two are different but ether functional group there, okay? And C2H5OC2H5, so is it ether or not? Ether, okay? So now this is the functional group priority order. Now which one has most important functional group, which one get the first priority? Carboxylic acid. Next priority goes to cyanide. Next priority goes to aldehyde. Next priority goes to ketone and alcohol. So let's see why we are discussing this here. So here we are discussing initially, that is primary prefix. Primary prefix represents, it is secondary grade functional group, am I right? Secondary grade functional group or substituent, we call it is substituent, am I right, student? Substituent. And secondary suffix, we discuss about this also. Secondary suffix, what about this one? Secondary suffix, it tells about main functional group, main functional group, okay? So if the compound consists two or more functional group, okay students, two or more functional groups, we follow the functional group priority order to name the organic compounds, to name the organic compounds. So if two functional groups are there in the same compound, then we follow this functional group priority order. High priority high priority functional group is taken as main functional group. Main functional group, that is secondary suffix as secondary suffix. Okay. Least priority functional group. Least priority functional group taken as secondary prefix, that is as substituent. Is it clear, student? Main functional, if two functional groups are there in the same compound, suppose carboxylic acid and cyanides, okay, in that particular case carboxylic acid taken as main functional group, that means secondary suffix, and cyanides taken as secondary prefix, that is substituent. So remember this point, very very important. So according to functional group priority order, okay, so let us see the example here. And one more important thing here, note, halogens means fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine, simply we can represent X, these are all, X may be fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, okay, halogens taken as only secondary prefix, that is substituents only, not a functional group, only substituents, we consider as only secondary prefix, okay, not a main functional, not a main functional group, okay, only substituent, secondary prefix only. And one more important point here, alkyl groups means here, suppose we can represent this is R, for examples CH3, we have, what is the name of CH3? Methyl is alkyl group, okay, and what about ethyl group? C2H5, ethyl group, these are called as alkyl groups, these are always considered as substituents. Substituents, okay, and one more important point here, NO2 group, this is called nitro group, NO2 group is called as nitro group, this is always considered as secondary prefix is called as substituent, am I right? Substituent. Here also substituents means secondary prefix. Okay, students? Secondary prefix. Okay. NO2 group. And one more important point here we should need to remember, phenyl group means we can represent this as pH bond, phenyl group means it is also considered as substituent. Substituents means secondary prefix. Okay, phenyl group. So NO2 halogens and nitro and phenyl group always considered as secondary prefix only. That means taken as only substituents. Remember that point. So what about phenyl group? Phenyl group means we can represent this like this, am I right? PH. Okay. So phenyl group means. So what about benzene? Benzene, we have the compound benzene. Okay. The formula of benzene is C6H6. Students, clear? How many carbon? 6 carbon. And how many hydrogen? 6 hydrogens. Now this formula for benzene, now its structure is like this. So very very important in organic chemistry. How many carbons here we have? 6 carbons, clear? Okay. And each carbon consists of one hydrogen. How many hydrogens? One hydrogen. Okay. And it consists some double bonds. Suppose here we keep the double bond here. Now it is single. Again it is double bond. Single bond, double bond. Okay. Double bond, single bond. Double bond, single bond. Double bond, single bond. This is called benzene structure. Benzene structure. Now, if you remove one hydrogen here, then what is the structure? Not only here, from any place remove one hydrogen, either here or here, here, okay. So any place remove one hydrogen. Suppose I would like to remove the hydrogen here, okay. So now, what is the valence of carbon here? 1, 2, 3 only. But carbon always tetravalence. That means it can able to form 4 bonds. So here the bond is required, am I right? Now this carbon can able to form with another atom. Suppose X. It can able to form with another atom. It may be X, halogen or hydrogen or NO2 group, whatever it. So here we can represent simply like this. That means, okay, no hydrogen here. Now this is called, we can able to keep any group here. Suppose NO2 or chlorine or bromine or iodine, like this, such kind of groups we can able to keep here at this carbon. Now it can satisfy 4 bonds, okay. Here no atom, remember this. Now this ring is called as, this structure is called as phenyl ring we call it. Simply we denote this pH bond. This bond means this representation. pH means this is entire structure pH. This is represents. So if you can add chlorine, bromine or iodine, whatever it here, okay, so their carbon satisfy tetravalency, am I right? Now it is only 3 valency, 1, 2, 3, only 3 valency. Now it can able to form another bond with any other atoms like nitro, NO2, chlorine, bromine, iodine, like that, okay. So remove just one hydrogen from the benzene ring, then the ring is called as phenyl ring, okay, remember this. So this can also always considered as substituents, okay. Remember this point. So let us take the example. CH3, CH2,
CH2CH OH COOH.
This is the organic compound. Okay. How many functional groups here we have, students? Here we have two functional groups. So here we have, it is COOH and OH is also there. Two are functional group, am I right? Now which one, my question is, which one act as main functional group, main functional group, okay? Main functional group means secondary suffix. And second question is, which one act as substituent or secondary prefix. Here we have two functional group. Okay, now we know the functional group priority order. What it is? First one, carboxylic acid. Okay, then we go for cyanides, then we go for aldehyde, then we go for ketone. Okay, then we go for alcohols, then we go for amines, and finally we go for ethers, and then double bond, comma triple bond, both are having nearly same priority. Okay, so now if here we need to check the priority of order of the functional group. Here we have two types of functional group, one is COOH, another one is alcohol. So which one has more priority functional group? So COOH is the more priority functional group. More priority functional group, am I right? Then comparing with OH, am I right? OH is at after ketone. So now this gets first priority, okay? So now answer is which one act as main functional group or secondary functional group? COOH, that is carboxylic acid group, taken as main functional group. Is it clear, student? According to priority order, functional group priority order. Okay, main functional group, taken as main functional group means that is secondary suffix. Okay, now what about which one act as substituent or secondary prefix? OH group, taken as substituent or secondary prefix. When compared with COOH, substituent or secondary, when comparing with COOH, is it clear, students? According to functional group priority order. So here it is substituent. This is main functional group. We give the first priority this group. Is it clear, students? Did you get the concept? Okay.
नेक्स्ट गो टू IUPAC रूल्स, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट.
सो इज इट क्लियर अप टू एवरीवन? सो व्हाट इज फंक्शनल ग्रुप? यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर फ्रॉम व्हाट इज फंक्शनल ग्रुप एंड वी गिव द IUPAC नेम इंट्रोडक्शन एंड देर इज एन ऑर्डर प्राइमरी प्रीफिक्स सेकेंडरी सफिक्स एंड अबाउट रूट वर्ड्स. ओके देन वी नीड टू डिस्कस अबाउट दिस टॉपिक. ओके फंक्शनल ग्रुप प्रायोरिटी ऑर्डर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड नाउ वी गो फॉर IUPAC रूल्स. IUPAC रूल्स वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट.
IUPAC rules here. IUPAC rules. Let's see in that we have the first rule. So these rules are very very important to give the names to the organic compounds. Okay.
So why it is methane? Why it is ethane? Propane, heptane, like that. How to we give the names to the organic compounds? That depends on these concepts up to and this is the main rules. Okay. In that we have the rule one,
we have to select longest or parent carbon chain in the given organic compound. In the given organic compounds. So we have to select the longest or parent hydrocarbon chain in the given organic compound. Our longest carbon chain, already we discussed about this. Let's see the example. So let's see the model example, then you get an idea about these. So in the while we are giving the names to the organic compound, first you have to select the longest carbon chain in the given organic compound. Longest carbon chain, that is a very very important point. So let's see 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, so this is the compound suppose. Now in this compound, first you have to select the longest carbon chain, that is parent carbon chain. Okay, now which one is main chain here? That chain consists maximum number of carbons continuously, there is no break. So let's see 1 2 3. Suppose if you move in this direction, okay, 1 2 3 4 5 6 carbons. How many carbons? 6 carbons in this direction. 6 carbons. Okay, is it clear? And next possibility in this compound, 6 carbons in this direction, maximum number of carbons 6 carbons. Okay, just keep like this. This is the branch, this is the main chain or parent chain. Let us come to okay. Suppose in this direction, this is the compound, the same compound I gave you. Now I would like to move in this direction. Now okay, suppose this is the main chain. Now count it, how many carbons? 1 2 3 4 5 only. Now this is a branch, so this is the main chain. Suppose I would like to take, okay, how many carbons here? 1 2 3 4 5, only 5 carbons only in the main chain. And third possibility, suppose
I want to move in this direction like this. Now this is considered as main chain. Suppose how many carbons? 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons only. 4 carbons. We have to select longest or parent carbon chain in the given organic compound. Longest carbon chain. Now which one is the longest carbon chain? Here it consists 6 carbon. It consists in this direction 5, and in this direction it is only 4 carbons in the main chain. Suppose. So now which one? What is the good selection? Okay. So that chain consists of maximum number of carbons continuously. Okay. Here 6 carbons, 5 carbons, and here it is 4 carbons. Okay. Now this representation is correct. We have to select the longest carbon chain. Clear? Why? Because 5 carbons, 4 carbons. That method is wrong. Now in this compound, this is the correct direction to select the longest carbon chain. Is it clear, students? So now, what about this one? This is main chain. This chain is called as main chain, and also we call it is parent chain, and also we call it is longest chain. This chain consists maximum carbon atoms. Okay. And what about this one? Now this is the branch. This is the main branch. This is sub branch. Okay. This is sub branch. Or we call it is substituent. What we call it is substituent. This is the main branch or sub. This is a sub branch or substituent. This is main branch. Longest carbon chain. Continuously the carbons are available. Now these are the side chains. Side chain. We consider these as substituent. Most we use this term substituent. Here this carbon acts as substituent. Okay, clear student? Up to. So now this is the wrong method to give the longest carbon chain representation. So longest carbon chain means that representation is very very important. Okay. Let us take one more example to. This is the compound. Now select the longest carbon chain. In which direction you have to prefer? Suppose if you move in this direction, 1, 2, 3, 4. Suppose if you want to move in this direction, this is the longest chain. Now these two are substituents, am I right? This is one substituent, this is another substituent, am I right? This is main chain. That main chain consists of how many carbon, students? 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons. Four carbons. Okay. So next possibility here. The next possibility here. Suppose if you move. In this direction, now this one becomes substituents, these two are becomes two substituents. This is one substituent, this is another substituent. Okay. Now this is the main chain. Count it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 carbons are there. So totally how many carbons? 8 carbons in the longest chain. Now this is the become longest chain. Okay. So another possibility here. Suppose I would like to take in this direction. Either in this direction, both are same. Okay. Now count it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons only. 5 carbons. Now this act as, this enter act as. Why? Because this is enter attached to at main chain here. This entire structure attached to this carbon. So now entire this is taken as substituent. One substituent. Remember this. Okay. Now, which chain consists of maximum number of carbons? That is called main carbon chain or parent carbon chain or longest carbon chain. Now, which one is correct, student?
Yes.
Now, it consists of 4 carbons. It consists of 5 carbons, suppose in this manner. In this manner, this chain consists of 8 carbons maximum. Am I right? So, now this method is correct. This is the longest continuous chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Continuously, there is no break. Okay? So, now this is also wrong. This is also wrong. This is the longest chain for this given compound. Okay? So, which method is correct to select the long chain? This method is extraordinary method to select the longest carbon chain. That is the longest chain. Okay? So, what is the first rule? We have to select the longest parent carbon chain in the given organic compound. Okay? This is the method. Let's see some important example here. So which one is the longest chain in this compound? Suppose if you move in this direction, 1, 2, 3, 4, then this becomes, suppose if you move in this direction, this becomes 3 carbons it consists, am I right? 3 carbons only, this is become substituent. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 carbon it consists, this is the main chain. Suppose for the same compound, for the same compound, so I would like to move in this direction. Count it, how many carbons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons. Now these two are substituents. These two are substituents. Clear, students? It consists of 4, this consists 5 carbons. Is there any other possibility? Okay. Now count it, how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons in the main chain. Now these two are act as substituents. Why? Because these two are attached to main chain. So now which method is correct one? Here it is only 4 carbons. So this is wrong method. Here it is 5 carbons. Here it is also 5 carbons. And two substituents here we have. Here also two substituents with 5 carbon. These two are correct. So which one? At least one we have to select in these two. Okay, here it consists two substituents. It is also, it consists two substituents. The longest carbon consists 5 carbons. Here also longest carbon consists 5 carbons, two substituents. Okay, clear? So this is the longest chain. So any one of these two are correct. Okay. Select longest chain. Suppose I think this is the longest chain. Clear? These two are substituents. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 carbons. This is the maximum number of carbon chain. This method is correct one. This is the longest carbon chain here. Okay? Clear? So let's see.
Which one is the longest chain? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Suppose this is the longest chain, this is substituent then. Now suppose 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is the longest chain. 4 plus 3. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Longest 7 carbons are here. Suppose if we can move in this direction, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 only. 6 only. But here in this direction, 7. Okay, clear student? That is the longest chain. And the next one is CH3 bond CH2, CH bond CCH3, CH3, CH3, bond CH2, bond CH3. Okay student, now select the longest chain. Suppose if you can move in this direction, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay, 6, now this one becomes substituent, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 only, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 only, so now this is the longest chain. Okay, clear. Now this one becomes substituent. This is substituent. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Now here it is substituent. Remember this. Clear. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Suppose if you can move like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's see the result carefully, students. Here we have some important point in this structure. That is, in this direction, it consists 6 carbons, 1 substituent. This is entire substituent. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Suppose if you can move like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's see the same structure. Which one is correct one in this case? The same structure. Okay. Suppose I would like to move in this direction. Now count it, how many carbons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many substituents? 1, 2, 3 substituents here we have. Okay. So here also it can't say 6 carbons. Okay, but how many substituents? 1, 2, 3 substituents. 3 substituents and 6 carbon chain. Okay, here it is 6 carbons and 1 substituent only. 1 substituent, this is entirely 1. We have to select maximum number of substituent chain. Maximum number of substituent chain now. So now this is wrong. In this case, this is wrong. Why? Because this carbon consists 6 carbons and this carbon consists 6 carbon and 1 substituent only. Why? Because this is entirely attached to this carbon. So we can say this is 1 substituent. But come to here, it consists 6 carbons, the same compound. In this direction, it consists 6 carbons. Okay? But it consists 3 substituents here. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So more substituted long chain is better to select it. Okay? This is the correct method. Remember. In these two, this one is the correct method. In this, this is the law. Why? Because it consists more substituents. Is it clear? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 ma. Clear? And one substituent. Suppose if we can move in this direction. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then how many substituents? 3 substituents. More substituted long chain is better to select. To give the name. Okay? So very, very important. Here 6 carbons, here also 6 carbons. But where the difference? In the case of substituents, side chains. So here only one side chain, it is 3 sides. So we have to select this one. Okay? Remember this. So now what is the first point here? We have to select longest carbon chain.
Now, which is the longest chain for this compound? Suppose option A. I think this is the longest chain. This one becomes substituent. Option B. I have to select here in the second option. This is the longest chain. This is substituent. Option C. A and B, D none. Which one is correct? Which one is the longest chain for this one? So, in this direction, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 carbons, 1 branch chain. Suppose in this direction, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons, 1 chain. Suppose here one more option. I would like to change. CH3. CH2, CH, CH3, CH3. Suppose I want to move in this direction. Okay. Wherever the carbon shows tetravalency. Here carbon one bonded with this carbon and three hydrogen. Tetravalence, remember this. How many carbons here? Now this becomes substituent. How many carbons it consists? 1, 2, 3 carbons only. Here it is 4 carbon, 1 substituent. Here it is 4 carbon, 1 substituent. Okay. Now option D all, which one is correct, ma students? Option A and B, both are correct. Why? Because suppose it is the longest chain, it consists of one substituent. The longest chain consists of how many carbons? 4 carbons. Suppose this is the longest chain, this consists of 4 carbons, one substituent, like this. So now both are correction. Both are correct. Okay, now this is wrong. Why? Because in the long chain it consists of only 3 carbon and one substituent only. So least number of carbons here we have, and comparing with these two. Okay. So now this is the correct option. Okay. So remember this. Okay, students. Again, we'll meet on tomorrow. Have a nice day. Thank you very much.